Welcome to Cimbrer Bushcraft, and welcome to the series Bushcraft from A to Z. And today it's the letter K, and I would like to tell you about all my knives. These 21 knives you see here is knives I've collected throughout my life. And I would like to tell you the stories about each knife. Some stories are very short and some are a little bit longer, but hang on. I believe this is the oldest knife I have. I can remember I got that when I was about 9 or 10 years old. Originally it had a sheath that was made of metal. I think it was iron or perhaps aluminium. And it also had a handguard there. I've used this knife a lot. You can see it's been beaten a little bit. I think it's a sewing. But the special thing about this knife is it's a replicate or a copy. Or this type of knife was the same they used in Hitlerjugend in the 30s and in the World War II. That's some history. You can look it up on the internet. And then you can see the story about this knife. Yeah. And the next knife is this one. This one I bought in France, in a city called Rouen, near Paris. And I bought that this knife when I was a sailor. And this was my first knife that I used when I was out sailing. It's a fisher's knife made in Finland. And it's just very sharp, and you can see it has a nice Scandi grind. Very, and the sheet, well, it has looked better, but it's still a nice sheet. And this knife was also rather expensive when I bought that. And then I have my Bowie knife. This Bowie knife, you can see, original Bowie knife. This knife I got in a present from a girlfriend I knew once. It came with the blade separate and the handle that I should make my handle, own my handle, and put it on. And then I have this knife. This is also a very old knife, and I can't remember the name of it anymore. It has a very special sheet that protects the knives, the knife and the handle. And this wasn't a Scandi grind from the start, so I tried to make it a Scandi grind, a long Scandi grind, but yeah, I never succeeded completely. You can see I haven't grind it down enough. This knife, I believe, is about 30 years old. And then I have a Helle knife. And this knife is a newling, they call it, with birch handle. It's very nice. It's very cool knife. And the sheet is, I love the sheet. This one I've used many times in Norway, when I've been hiking up there, and also worn it in a daily basis when the law still allowed that. And this one is almost the same. It's a Fjording Helle knife, and it's almost the same. The only difference is the thickness of the handle. You can see this one, the newling, is much thicker than the Fjording. And the sheet, well, it is leather, but I don't like the design. This one, you can see the sheet I've made myself. It's a stainless steel. It only about $20, I think, But the only reason why I bought this knife was because of the sheath that was with it. See, it fits right in there. Later I will tell you about a knife, a very expensive knife I have, but the sheath for that was very awful. So I bought this knife to get the sheath to that knife, and I'll tell you that later. But this knife I never used, actually. Although it's a nice knife. And then I have a scout knife, and I think I bought this for my son sometime, but he never got the same passion for knives as I do. So I've kept it as a memory, and you can see it's almost brand new. No scratches on it. And it's a children knife, children's knife. And this one is a little, also a little children's knife. I think I bought this for my daughter, but again, she didn't got the passion for knives, so I kept it. This one has been used a little bit more, you can see, and it is bought up in Norway. But it's a very nice little thing. And the last of the cheap knives, this one I bought from a friend once, and it has a kydex sheet, and originally it was black coated, and I've taken the coat off, but it didn't work as good as my Essie knives. I couldn't get it completely off, so I stopped sometimes in the process, and perhaps one day I'll continue it with this process, and it will be a nice clean and sharp knife. It has a rubber handle, and I think it's full tang. Yeah, it is. The reason why I bought this very cheap is because it's a little handy knife, tactical knife, or Mora knives. And this one I just got as a Christmas present. It's for carving, and it's carbon steel. I can see it's almost beginning to rust. And this one I used to make spoons and cups, a hollow knife. And it's very, very sharp. This one I've had about almost a year when I started trying to carve spoons and so on. But two very nice small knives. And I have a little story about Mora knives. I know I have had a Mora knife. At that time it was a red handle, and the blade was a little longer than this. And the reason why I decided not to have a Mora anymore is because they have no handguard on here. So once, I think I was about 10 years old, I had wet fingers, and I hold the knife like this, and I put it down very hard, and my hand slipped down, and I cut myself. And I don't know if you can see it still, but I have 3 marks on my fingers, and it fits perfectly that the knife could cut here. So that's a memory too from a Mora knife. A little funny story. Well, then I have these knives. It's a Brusoletto, I think it's called. Yes, and it's a Norwegian knife. This one I've bought in Norway, in a little town called Jianga, a very lovely place. And this knife, yeah, I think it was about $150. So, yeah, my wife think it's expensive. And so you can see there's graving in here, in the handle. And again, I think it's Björk you call it birch, and the sheet is a sheet. It's very nice. You can see there's ornaments in this. And this one has a Scandi grind too, and I've used this a lot of time in Norway, and I love it. I also made my own knives. This one is the first I made. The blades, I have two knives I made. This one too. The blades I bought, they were finished, so I only put the handle on. But I like this little knife. This is a camel bone, I think. And I made the sheet for it. As you can see, I put something on to make it a little bit more interesting. And it fits perfectly down there. This one I haven't used a lot, but I have it on display in my living room. This one was my next project, and the same, I bought the blade. The blade was so long when I bought it, so I cut it off and rounded it. And this is Damascus steel. This is, I don't know what it's called, a Taxus handle, and with the brass pins in. I love this. And I also made this little, yeah, just to make it fine. And as you can see, a little sheet for it. At first, I made it so that it couldn't be placed on my belt. But later, I made it all. I rearranged it so it could be a neck knife, so I can put the lanyard in here and use that as a neck knife. But because of this thing I put on here, it's very difficult to get in the sheet again, so it's a little bit annoying. So I don't use that as a neck knife anymore. But I love it, and I'm very proud of the result of it. Yes. Another neck knife I bought. This is, a condor. A little knife that is carbon steel. And I've done the same thing with this as with my Izzy knife. I stripped all the paint off and gun blacked it and put a little leather handle on. This is a very nice little knife, but it's a little bit too small, even for a neck knife. So this is in my box with all my other knives that I doesn't use. And then the last of these, this one I got in Christmas last year, in 2016. And actually it is a spear. See, you can screw this one off. And you can place it on a stick so that you can use it as a spear if you're fishing. This is most a survival knife. I've never used it because it's too big to carry around. But when I got it in Christmas present, I was very fond of it. Now we are with our neck knife. This is the neck knife I use at the moment. It's a Izzy and Sula, and I love this knife. It's a little bit bigger than the condor knife, you can see comparison, especially the handle is much better on the Insula. And again, the Insula, I've stripped it off for the plastic coat and put on some gun black on it. And I've customized the sheet a little bit. It's a kydex sheet, and it's very nice because it clicks in and it stays there. So This is the knife, the neck knife I use at the moment. Well, we're almost done. Then, sometime in the start of my bushcraft survival hobby, I bought this as it's a Burka, a survival knife from Germany. And it's a really nice knife. It's very thick in the blade and has a good handle. I made some changes. I've put some leather on here. Underneath there's some lanyard you can use in survival situation, and this you can screw off. It's a real Rambo knife, and you can put things down there. And I had a little thing, some fishing lines and matches and so on. The only reason why I bought my Essie 5 knife is because that one is carbon steel and this one is stainless steel. So, and it's very heavy. Actually, it's very, very heavy. Before I bought this, I saw some YouTube videos, and the ones that have tested it said that it was very, very rough and very durable, and they couldn't make it break. And the reason why these knives are not so popular is because they are not full tang. So it can break at this point, and in a survival situation that could be catastrophic, because if this is your only knife, well, you have to depend on it. Then my SE5 knife with my new sheet from Woodlander's leather, and well, I've shown this before. I love this knife. It's my primary knife. It's very thick in the blade. It has a good grip, and all in all, I'm very, very happy with it. And I can sharpen it razor blade sharp. So that's. And this one is about $250 here in Europe, but I think it's worth it. And now the last knife. Yeah, this is the knife I told you about earlier. The knife that I bought only for this sheet, and it was for this knife. And this knife is the most expensive I ever bought. I bought this 30 years ago, and at that moment it costed about $250. When I read on it here, the D.F. Kessler design, and on the other side, handmade by Anton Willinger Jr., Solingen, Germany, and it's called Integrate Hunter. I think it's a very, very good knife. It has a very nice handle and a blade, but again, it's stainless steel. This is my most expensive knife, $250 30 years ago. I don't know what it would cost today. Thank you for watching Cimbrer Bushcraft and the series Bushcraft from A to Z. And I hope you enjoyed the video and was inspired by all my knives. And I hope to see you on the next one. Take care. Bye bye.